Yes, Dad.
Are you following me?
Yeah. Bentar ya, saya lagi ganti pampers dulu.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
It's okay. Wait a minute. Intransitive, yes, sir.
Yeah, number one.
Let's invite your cousins as well.
Let's invite your cousin as well. Invite is the verb. Do you think it has an object here?
Transitive.
Yes, transitive, because letter is the object, right?
In the morning, that verb of time.
Yeah, don't focus about in the morning, yeah. Don't focus on it, because here we just need to see if the verb has object or not, or it is belongs to transitive or intransitive.
Number three,
I'm going to send her some flowers.
Transitive.
Yeah, transitive, yeah. Some flower, but her, yeah, her is the object, yeah, her.
Intransitive.
Yeah, intransitive. Yeah, no.
No.
Check here. Yes. Next, number five.
Intransitive.
Next, number 6. The loud noise woke me.
Sir, can I ask something? When we change number 5, when example we change the sentences become suddenly the child woke up and cry, berarti dia bakalan jadi transitif dong, sir.
Woke up and cried. Okay, in your sentence has two verb, right? Woke and cried.
But not object.
No, yeah, but your verbs that do not have object, right?
Oh yeah.
Jadi, transitive itu tadi kan kita setuju mempunyai objek, ya? Objek itu contohnya seperti apa, ya? Yang itu yang nomor 1 ada contohnya. Me, ya, sebagai objek, direct object, ya, objek langsung. Kemudian contoh nomor 3, ya, her sebagai direct object, ya. Tapi contoh yang tadi itu, ya, hanya kata kerjanya 2 tapi tidak mempunyai objek.
Tidak mempunyai objek. Okay, sir.
Next number 6, the loud noise woke me. Yeah. Do you think the verb woke has object here?
Me.
Yes, me. Yeah. And number 7, let's discuss your plan. Do you think discuss has an object here?
Plan. Plane.
Direct object, ya. I heard a lovely song in the morning. No, right? It doesn't have an object, ya. And then can you lend me a few pounds? Yes. It is transitive.
Transitive.
Yeah. The wind was blowing fiercely. No, yeah. It doesn't have. Okay, now I want you make your own example, 1 or 2, yeah. One is transitive and one is intransitive. Can you do it? I will give you time, maybe 1 or 2 minutes, and then later when you finish, when you are ready, you can say your sentences. Can you do it? Satu kalimat yang kata kerjanya mempunyai objek dan satu lagi kata kerjanya tidak mempunyai objek, ya. It's okay, yeah, don't worry, we just practice. If you are ready, you can just let me know. One is transitive and one is intransitive.
Sir, I won't try.
Yes, your name?
Ika.
Okay.
Ethic reads a book. Transitive. And then Ethi is reading. Intransitive.
Yes.
You're welcome.
And what others? Maybe they want to try?
I want to try, sir. 一个 was cry yesterday. Intransitive.
一个
was cry.
Cry yesterday.
Yeah. 一个 cry yesterday.
Yes, it is intransitive, right?
Intransitive, yes. And then, Ike is going to the market to buy some fruits.
All right, and then what is the object in your sentence?
The object on the my sentence is some fruits.
Ike is going to buy some fruit.
Fruits.
Yeah, in the market. Ike is going to buy
some fruits
in the market. Your verb is buy and then your object is some fruit. Yes, very good. I like it. I like your example. What about others? They want to try maybe? No? If you finish, maybe we can continue to another topic. Right, now, what is an object? We want to know more about what is object. Is a part of a sentence and often part of a predicate. It refers to someone or something involved in the subject performance of the verb. Object itu katanya sebuah bagian dari sebuah kalimat dan sering menjadi bagian daripada predicate atau kata kerja. Itu mengacu kepada seseorang atau sesuatu yang involve, ya, termasuk dalam in the subject performance of the verb, dalam tindakan si subject, ya, di kata kerja. Contohnya di sini, ya, Leila wrote the poem, ya, Leila wrote the poem. The subject is Leila, ya. She did something job, ya. She did something job about the poem. Ya. So Leila is the subject, the doer of the performance, ya. Doer or performance artinya pelaku, ya. Pelaku. And then wrote is a verb that refers to the action, ya. Action by the subject Leila. And the poem is the object involved in the action. Ya. Nah, poem itu puisi, ya. Puisi itu bagian daripada si predikat atau kata kerja, ya. Yaitu tindakan yang dilakukan. So a direct object is the receiver of the action within a sentence, as in example, he hit the ball. Yeah, he hit the ball. So the ball is the direct object. While indirect object identifies to or for whom or what the action of the verbs is performed. Example: grandfather left Rosalita and Raul all his money. Sementara kalau dia objek tidak langsung mengidentifikasi kepada siapa atau apa tindakan daripada si performan dalam kata kerja. Contohnya, ya, all his money sebagai objek tidak langsung. Kemudian, what is object complements? An object complements follow and modifies or refers to a direct object. It can be a noun or adjective or any word acting as a noun or adjective. So here the pattern is the subject, verb, object, and adjective. Example, the court ruled his actions illegal. The winter called him a criminal. Yeah, a criminal as the noun. And another example, I found the guard sleeping. Yeah, so the guard as the direct object and sleeping object complement atau objek pelengkap. And then we all consider her unworthy. Jadi direct object itu selalu terdapat setelah kata kerja utama, ya. Dan objek complement atau objek pelengkap itu adalah setelah direct object, objek langsung, diikuti objek langsung. Now identify direct object or indirect object. Number one, I find it fascinating. Fascinating, it is like interesting, yeah. It's the synonym of interesting. Menarik. Alright, so number one, do you think it is direct or indirect object?
Object.
Yes. They call their new baby April. I think this is indirect object, right? Indirect object. And the last one, he was appointed assistant professor. This is direct object also. Okay. Next, we go to another section about type of phrase. Yeah, type of phrase, jenis-jenis frasa. Ada adjective phrase dan ada adverb phrase. Adjective phrase, group of words function as adjective. consists of adjective modifiers and any word that modifies noun or pronoun in the sentence. Iya, jadi adjective phrase itu berfungsi sebagai kata sifat, ya. Namanya sudah adjective, berarti kata sifat, rasa kata sifat yang memodifikasi ya kata benda ya atau kata ganti benda dalam kalimat. Contohnya, she is wearing a beautiful dress. A beautiful dress ini sebagai adjective phrase. Masih ingat kan apa yang dimaksud dengan frasa? Do you still remember what is phrase? Phrase is a group of words ya. Frasa itu grup kata-kata ya yang mempunyai arti kesatuan. So, the next example, the boy in the red shirt is my brother. The red shirt, adjective phrase. Adjective-nya di situ red ya. Sama dengan contoh yang pertama, adjective-nya dress. Dress beautiful, sorry, beautiful sebagai adjective ya, menjelaskan atau memodifikasi lebih lagi tentang si dress. Dress sebagai kata benda ya. Red adjective, shirt kata benda. Jadi si red ini menjelaskan lebih lagi ya informasi tentang si kata benda, si noun, shirt. Now can you make your example by using adjective phrase? Supaya kalian lebih paham ya, kita langsung ke contoh lah. Okay, I will give you time ya. You can make one only sentence with adjective phrase.
Jadi disuruh buat contoh lah. You ask the student to make a sample.
Yes, make your own example by using adjective phrase.
The man. Oh.
okay. Don't worry if you make mistake. We can correct together. Just try your best.
The girl with the short hair is my sister.
Yes, the girl with the short hair is my sister. The girl with the short hair is my sister. Can you let me know what is adjective phrase in your sentence? You have adjective phrase. Can you just tell me what is adjective phrase?
Adjective phrase is short hair, yes. Kata keterangan, yes.
Short sebagai adjective. Short adjective, hair noun. Jadi si adjektifnya menjelaskan lebih detail lagi, ya kan? Lebih informatif lagi tentang si kata benda noun-nya. Hair, short hair. Very good. Ya, yeah, I like your example. Very good. It's perfect. What about others? They wanna try?
Me.
Yes, please. Mbak Etty.
Ike sih, sir. Barusan itu etik.
Oh, iya,
Mbak Ike. Cuman dua student, sir, di sini. Ike dan Etik.
Yeah, you all very active. You both very active. I like it.
She was wearing red dress. The adjective is red. And then dress is noun.
Yes, she was wearing it. She was wearing red dress. Yes, red dress as the adjective phrase, right? Red dress adjective phrase. Red as the adjective and then dress as the noun. Yeah. Okay. Thank you for your participation. Now we move on to adverb of phrase. Yeah. Group of words function as adverb consists of adverb and other words. Preposition, verb, noun, and modifiers. Jadi adverb phrase ini berfungsi sebagai kata keterangan, ya. Adverb itu kata kerja keterangan yang terdiri dari prepositional verbs, ya, kata kerja yang mempunyai kata depan preposition, kemudian kata benda atau kata or other modifiers as well. Example, she always talk in a good way. Ya, ini sebagai prepositional verb. Ya, prepositional verb. Di sini kata depannya in. Ya, kemudian verbnya good way. Ya, good way. And then she was shouting in a loud voice. In a loud voice, prepositional verb, ya. In sebagai kata depannya. Next, prepositional phrase, ya. Masuk kita kata depan. Concept of preposition, object of preposition, noun of preposition, and may also have modifiers. Yang dimaksud dengan prepositional phrase itu adalah frasa yang diawali dengan kata depan. Ya, ada berapa yang kalian ketahui kata depan? Ada berapa yang kalian ketahui tentang kata depan? In English,
in, on, at, before, after.
Yes, very good. Yeah, in, at, on, by, off, from, with. Yeah, they are prepositional. Nah, contohnya ya. Dalam kalimat a girl at the corner of the class is Amina. So at the corner prepositional phrase ya, karena diawali dengan kata depan at ya. And then she sings in a loud voice. In a loud voice prepositional phrase karena diawali dengan kata depan in. Now, can you make your own sentence, only one, using prepositional phrase, please? Tell me when you are ready, and then say your sentence.
The cat is sit on the chair.
And then what is your prepositional phrase?
On the chair. On.
Yeah, on the chair. It is
yes,
prepositional phrase. Okay, very good. On the chair. Yeah, on the chair. What about others? Imperative sentence ini adalah kalimat perintah, ya. Kalimat perintah atau permintaan, ya. Contohnya, close the door. Ya. Kalimat perintah ini tidak memiliki subjek, ya, tidak memiliki subjek umumnya, jarang memiliki subjek, yang hanya kata kerja dan juga noun phrase dalam kalimat. Contohnya close the door sebagai close sebagai kata kerja, the door noun phrase. Di sini tidak ada subjek. Biasanya kalimat perintah ini terkadang ada kata please, ya. Please close the door. Please go to school. Please kindly lend me your book. Ya. Please call your sister. Jadi fungsi daripada kata please ini adalah lebih sopan. Next, what is noun phrase? Consists of noun and related words modifiers. It functions like a noun in the sentence. The girl on the stage is singing. Yeah. The girl on the stairs has function as not praise. And the girl with the blue eyes broke a beautiful dress. The girl with the blue eyes as the not praise. Determiners. Determiners are words placed in front of a noun. Noun phrase to make clear what the noun refers to. Jadi ada empat jenis determiners. Possessive atau kepemilikan, ya. My, your, her, his, each, our, you, their. Kemudian quantifiers. Some, any, each, no. Demonstrative tingkat. This, that, these, those, and WH determiners whose, what, which. Use A or N, the indefinite article, when the thing you are referring to is not specific. Article A dan N, kita menggunakannya ketika benda tersebut belum spesifik, ya, belum diketahui antara si pembicara dan pendengar. Contohnya, I bought a book last week. A book, sebuah buku. Bisa saja si pembicara, si pendengar tidak tahu buku yang mana, ya, buku yang mana. Kemudian, you should bring an umbrella. It doesn't matter which umbrella you bring. Jadi, an umbrella. Payung yang dimaksud di sini tidak spesifik. Mau payung yang mana saja boleh. Ya, tidak harus payung tertentu. Jadi, A dan N ini digunakan ketika benda tersebut belum spesifik yang mana yang dibicarakan. Berbeda dengan the, ya, the atau disebut dengan definite article. Di sini lebih spesifik, ya, artinya si pembicara dan si pendengar tahu benda yang mana yang dimaksud, ya. Contohnya, I bought the rice cooker last week. The rice cooker berarti sudah pasti rice cooker yang mana yang dimaksud si pembicara. Dan si pendengar juga dia paham dan tahu rice cooker yang mana. Kemudian use the definite article the in the following cases. The with the superlative. Kita menggunakan kata the dalam tingkatan paling, ya, superlatif paling. Contohnya the best, the cheapest, the most, ya. And then the with ordinal numbers, the first, the second, the third. And then with same, with half the same, ya, the same math class this semester. Now, can you make your own example with using A or N and also using the? You can make your own example using A or N or using the. discussed involving articles.
Wait. I write an article about Indonesian's culture in Taiwan.
We don't know yet which kind of article is it, right? I mean that more specific about the article, we don't know more information about it. Yes, it's correct. What about the?
The is the itu yang belum jelas ya, sir. Maksudnya
the yang spesifik, ya, the yang spesifik.
The yang spesifik.
Ya.
The book with red color is mine.
Yes, the book with the red color is mine. Yeah, it's correct. Thank you so much. Next here we have exercise, yeah? Correct the errors involving articles. So,
sir, I cannot see your slides in the our screen.
Really?
Yes, it's a few minutes ago.
What about now? Is it working?
I can see.
Still cannot?
Still cannot, sir. I don't know. Suddenly it's happened.
Okay, what about now?
I still cannot see, sir. I don't know. Maybe is the signal is bad or something. Not yet. Not yet, sir, but our time is already finished in the